much better. So I'm curious to see Shen. Is the lock-in for
Rogue? I like this. It gives an avenue for Rogue to play the game, because honestly, right now, Rogue's composition up until that Shen pick was a glass cannon.
Schalke blue side, but Gilius is still pushing.
He has smite advantage, so Inspired's going to be able to pick this one up, take some damage on the way out here, but now map Larson should likely be split, but yeah, Larson on the way.
Yeah, where's Gilius going to go here? Like, he has to flash away. Larson's still chasing. Limit's working his way up from the bottom lane as well. Gilius going to EQ across the wall. Larson dashing forward as well. Limit is here for a little bit of protection. Trimby isn't going to go in. Limit looking for the damage onto Trimby. Flash, attract, repel, and Trimby goes down. First blood to Limit. Hansama chased away as well. As you can see, Gilius going in. Hansama has to flash, and Ender is the perfect.
As you say, you can kind of see those CS discrepancies going the way we'd expect them.
Larson is ahead in the mid lane. Neon, because of that early kill, because of the early pressure, is now ahead in the bottom lane. And Inspired is trying to come and join his bottom lane just to try and give him a little bit more pressure. Neon with the stun still taken out underneath the turret, and Limit will just Rakan pick from Rogue. I think the Shen last really rounds out their composition, because Rakan, Zaya, if they'd just been that, as the Shockwave goes down here in the middle lane, you can see Limit still on the chase. Stand United coming out onto Larson. One more auto attack would be enough. Odo Omnes teleport is stopped, and Abadage flashes in for the kill. Here's the Weaver's Ward in the top lane as Broken Blade tries to flash away. Diving back in, uses the wall, dives onto Odo Omnes, but is knocked back from the final auto. And Broken Blade with no mana and no hope of getting
no
away.
No mana on Inspired either.
Chasing him down. You say that, Ender. Gilius is on his way. Broken Blade, one auto, it's dead! Gilius slams down with the power of the
Dragon. For Herald slash pressure trade that we've seen so many times throughout the LEC. Usually Rogue are actually
just, you cry for them.
Dude, you gotta get over it. You gotta get over it. Here, Trimby's making a play.
He is as Gilius jumps in, the quickness coming out. Trimby trying to get away, but there's the Cataclysm. Gilius has to flash away, and Hansama puts the feathers in the back. The Shockwave finds two, though, as Hansama
takes the safest route he can, hugging that wall. Neon looking for the steal here, isn't gonna be able to get anything across the wall. And you can see Rogue actually, they were forced away, and then they just walk back into the river. Larson walk back into the mid lane. Schalke now diving in, but Rogue have had enough time to reset. Inspire's coming in with Weaver's Ward. There's the Seismic Shove, and Broken Blade, even with the Hexag Ultimatum, has to flash away. Odo Amine now dived on by Gilius, who's low as well, takes two tower shots, uses the Gore Drinker, but a shot to the back from Larson will take
for a long time. Odo's just been chilling topside, letting Broken Blade push into him, and he's completely happy to do that. You time that right with a minion here. So again, it will be a turret trade once more, and if we actually look back to it, the Rift Herald that was taken by Gilius was supposed to net a turret in exchange for that bot lane one, but it didn't. It
just got this wave and push Rogue back towards their tower. Top lane tower is going to fall to the minions. Red turret goes down. As another tower goes in,
get locked down.
Yeah, and you're going to have to track Broken Blade's flank in this one. I think Odo's doing a great job of trying to push him away, but he might be caught himself. Neon goes in.
Inspire's going to get dived on. Neon dives all the way onto the back line as the Cataclysm comes out, the quickness. And you can see Trimby trying to dive onto the back line as the Shockwave hits two. Odo Omnes low as well. Broken Blade still alive. Limit going down, ticking away. Neon going down as well. Hansama with the Featherstorm trying to do what he can. Abadage still alive on the back line as the Attract Repel has been procced onto him. Hansama flushes in. Broken Blade immediately dives onto him, and that was too greedy. That was too deep. Hansama as Rogue try and clear up the dragon at the end of the fight.
Hansama jumped in way too soon because Odo had actually based. He wanted to TP back into the minion wave and bot lane and get that flank off. And if he had time to do that,
he just can't catch a break, man.
Gilius, God of Jar.
Whoa.
Dive into the backline. Catches him coming out. Remember, Hansama doesn't have a flash as Neon gets the kill on Trimby, and Hansama is the target. Hextech Ultimatum will help them get the kills. Inspires down. It's a double for Neon. And one.
A good taunt off. Larson can open up with the big guns with the Light Slinger. Odo trying to step into the pit, but Rogue have given it up. Baron to Schalke. And with it, a bit of chunk on the tower as Broken Blade continues in the bottom lane.
Yeah, for Schalke, this Baron is all about taking, you know, these turrets when they can and not dying in a side lane. Broken Blade is able to sling away. So now Rogue's transition is going to be, well, we need vision on our top side. After we lost our mid-inner turret, well, that creates so much pressure on all of our jungle camps. Once you lose your outer turret, it usually means, well, that's going to be trouble for your Raptor camp, your Gromp camp. Once you lose inner, now your wolves are in play as well here. And with no wave clear in the bot side, this turret might fall as well.
Now, Schalke know that Larson was still in the top lane for a little while. Trimby stepping forward, jumping in. This is a 4v4 as Abadaga is in the mid lane. Turret should fall, just needs one more auto attack. Gilius tanks up a couple of towers.
The EQ flash combo, because I believe that if Rogue respect that, they can dodge away from that pretty easily. Trimby jumps in.
Gets the knock-up, gets the quickness. That's a little bit of damage down onto Limit.
A lot of damage down onto Limit,
and Abadaga is nowhere near this fight. Rogue, find a pick. And Schalke lose their support incredibly quickly. Broken Blade here pushing in the bottom lane as the Weaver's Wall comes out from Inspired, looking for the chase on towards that Camille. Broken Blade
Don't know if she has the wall dive. She does, as she dives away. Flashes back in. Here's the TP. Shauka looking to try take a trade here in the bottom lane. As Abadali joins the fight, Inspired, Stand United onto him. A kill of Instinct from Neon, but the Stand United keeps Inspired alive until the Shockwave comes down.
And here's the rest of Rogue, Medic. They're here to party. Larsen and Trimby are ready for the fight. They don't have Hantama. He's fighting Gilius in mid.
I mean, they don't have a huge amount. Larsen's going to pop the culling, but Neon and Abadali can actually win out this 2v2 trade. Odo Wamnik doesn't have well at all, because Rogue have already got this down to 3,000 HP, and Shauka nowhere near it. Broken Blade isn't here. Gilius tries to get in. There's a Cataclysm. Shockwave comes out as well. And the damage is huge. Magnus Storm doing a huge amount of work as Larsen and Huntsummer try and get away, but Broken Blade's on the chase. Featherstorm, Flash, Hextech, Old Amazon. Gilliam's still diving onto the back line as Killer Instinct comes out as well. And Neon is on the chase here as Broken Blade dives in once again. Shauka in a 3v1 will find the kill. And Rogue, you got the Baron, but you paid for it with your life.
They lost every single buff, and Shulka only lost one player. Shulka, they've got time too. They're going to march this minion wave up mid lane, and that may very well be the game.
It definitely could, as Shauka trying to push in mid here. You can see Huntsummer up in 26, Trimby up in 7. The question is, do Shauka have enough damage to clear this one out? The inhibitor is their next target.
They've got
Nexus
it, Medic.
Towers are up next, and we asked you earlier, we asked you guys, are Shauka the best team in the league? Well, at the moment, they're definitely the Giant Slayers.
Yep.
Last week, yep, Bazenda says, and this week they take down the undefeated once again. Shauka defeat Rogue.
How about that? Rogue is a